Has started. Good evening, everybody. My name is Godspower Ejafegbe. I'm a life coach. I'm also a forex trader. And to the glory of God, a whole lot of people have graduated from this academy. What's actually the aim? The aim is to teach people how to trade in the financial markets so that it will be so easy. There won't be any need to struggle in the forex market. I want you to just sit back, relax, as the training will be given to you all in full. Thank you for coming. All right, this is actually the one. Let me show you what I have on my screen, or what we'll be taking for today. Okay, my screen will display soon. Now, if you look at this clearly, Okay. I guess you all can see my screen. What exactly are we going to do for today? The truth about it is, if you are here for this program, just feel free. Don't have it in mind that some people are skilled in this already. Why I am not? I am actually going to start from the basics. And it is a station whereby you are learning from zero to hero. Are you with me? You are learning from zero to hero. Let's start. What do we have for today? Introduction to forex trading. We'll talk about exchange rates. We'll talk about fundamental analysis, technical analysis, and we'll see the review of the market. I'll make analysis via strategies and indicators. Are you with me? So that is what we'll be doing for today. Tomorrow, which I really advise you all not to miss, tomorrow will be a great one. We'll talk about pips, lots, leverage, brokers, platforms and charting softwares, types of traders, swing, day, position, scalp. Without looking into technical analysis, charts, candlesticks, trends, and indicators. Day three, which will be on Wednesday, we'll look into MetaTrader 400 and desktop version. How to use MetaTrader 4. Then we will now talk about how to open trades using MetaTrader 4. As at this day, I'll be sending you screen recorders on how to do these things. And I'll also teach you in the class and the whole of that. But have it in mind that from day three, trade management will commence. Day four, we look into how to manage your trade. The use of my Facebook, investing.com, Forex Factory, Trading View, then trading strategies that work, like support and resistance, BWAP, false breakout. We'll talk about break of structure. So let's start for today. What do we have for today? Day one. We're talking about looking at Forex. Class, what exactly is Forex? Forex is simply known as foreign exchange and is the largest financial market. The currencies are bought, sold, and exchanged for one another. Unlike the stock market, it has no centralized exchange and transactions are performed over the counter. That is, participants trade with one another through a worldwide network of banks, brokers, and other financial institutes. It is one of the most actively traded markets in the world, with an average volume of $5 trillion. Plus, what this means is, average daily, $5 to $5.2 trillion is dropped in the forex market. The question is, how much will you and I profit in a day? Like today, I'm telling you what's happened. I know how much I profited into my life account. This is actually drop for us to see how much we can get from the market. Now, Forex is just like a normal exchange. For instance, if you look at the Northerners, you want to convert your dollars to Naira, they tell you the rates and you make your exchange. Another good example is, for instance, I want to travel to Japan. I want to buy some spare parts, probably Toyota parts. I would have to convert my Naira to Yen. You know, Japanese is spending Yen, while Chinese is spending Yuan. I will have to convert my naira to yen. Then I travel with it. I deposit over that side. It's just a normal exchange journey with you. And we have done it severally today. You take money to the market, you buy fish, for instance, and you have it, you make an exchange of money, and what you see as what you are buying. Are you with me? So that is Forex. Are you with me? It's just a normal exchange. And it is actually traded 245. Are you with me? It is actually traded 245. For instance, it is traded from Mondays to Fridays. It is traded from what? From Mondays to Friday. What time zone are we looking at? London? London, in fact, that's where the currency GBP comes from, Great Britain pounds. You know, over there, they spend pounds and they spend pence. New York, you have USD and they spend them. The cobalt symbol for them is cent. Tokyo, Japan, they spend yen. Zurich, that's Swiss. They spend Swiss franc. Are you with me? Are you with me? Then Frankfurt, Hong Kong, Singapore, Singaporean dollar, Paris, Sydney, Australian AUD, so on and so forth. Are you with me? Now, what specific time are we talking about? You're looking at the Asia, Europe, and America. Are you with me? You're looking at the Asia, Europe, and America. These are the major sections we see when trading Forex. Class. What exactly do you do in the forex market? You do just two things. It is not like Bitcoin, whereby you buy, you sell. Then you now use Bitcoin to purchase some other items, you know? You know how Bitcoin seems to look like. Now, what exactly do you do in the forex market? In the forex market, you either buy or you sell. In the forex market, you do two things. You buy or you what? Or you sell. Now, have you sat down and asked yourself, who trades Forex? Have you sat down and asked yourself, who trades Forex? We have some specific bodies that trade Forex. The first one I'll be looking at is the central bank. And the central bank, we have several central banks in the world. Central Bank of Nigeria, we have European Central Bank, we have Bank of England, we have Bank of Japan, we have Bank of America, Bank of Canada. Are you thinking? All these, they trade Forex daily. They trade Forex daily. Ask yourself, where exactly do you think these banks, they get their money from? They get it from the trading they do mostly. It's not because of the 50 naira they deduct from your account. Are you thinking? They usually trade all of this. Now, the subordinate banks we are going to look at is the commercial bank. Commercial bank are Echo Bank, Keystone Bank, Polaris Bank, GT Bank, then Zenith, First Bank. All these banks are the commercial banks. Commercial banks are the subordinates. These are banks that usually come into the market. They are more or less like, they are linked to the central banks. Now, another body that trades Forex are multinational corporations. Multinational corporations can also build all these institutes that trade Forex. Are you with me? And in fact, they are so common now. You see some bodies that will tell you that bring 500,000 naira, we help you trade your money, and we'll give you 25% profit. See, those bodies you see, they are really doing a very strong work. Sometimes some of them, they don't survive it. Because when they burn your money, what happens? They might not proceed. But why is this training on? This training is actually on to teach you so that you can do this training yourself. As I am the one who is trading by myself. Nobody's trading for me. Are you with me? Nobody's trading for me. It's just that there must be a pattern you must follow up. You must never be breeding the forex market, and you must you must never be greedy, and you must be very patient. Are you doing? I will explain those things to you in subsequent classes. Let's proceed. Another body that trades Forex are the individual investors. Who are the individual investors? The individual investors are also the retail traders. The retail traders are you and I. How much do I even have in the Forex market? That, you know, my what I have in the market is nothing. compared to what the central banks or the commercial banks they have. I agree. But thank God for the brokers. In those days, can I assess the market? No. You know, technology has really gone far. In those days in fact, you hardly see check. What you see is postal order. Are you with me? You go to the bank, it is not as beautiful as it used to be. Are you with me? But now, with the broken firms, you can assess the market. You can tell when you need to withdraw your money. I used to hear some people saying that Forex, that it is rare, that you see, you put in money, you cannot withdraw your money. It's a big lie. It's a big lie. I make withdrawals anytime I want. And the money I have is even intact. In fact, as a matter of fact, I can even take some of my dollars and transfer it to my Nigeria account in dollars. I get it. So it depends on your exposure to this business. That's why you are here to have a very good idea of all these things. So individual investors, they also participate in trading, which we thank God for. In those days, remember very clearly, what do we do? Stock shares and stock brokers. You will tell yourself that I am buying shares from Guinness today. I am buying, like, I remember then, I used to buy, I'm talking about, way back 2006 or 2007. That's almost how many years ago now? Almost 14 years or something. Then you buy shares from Fidelity. You now wait for it to appreciate. You now be watching, you now be reading news, checking share section. Okay, your broker will now advise you. You are seeing your broker one-on-one. Your broker will advise you, okay, Mr. Gospower, this thing has appreciated to this point. You know one thing I've always noticed about those brokers? Brokers will never tell you that, sell your shares. I've always noticed it. They will always want to maintain your money. They are looking onto your money. Until one day, I noticed that there was this time, this global situation came. Remember very clearly, that was around 2008. I had to sell everything. Are you with me? I had to sell everything off. Why? Because the money has depreciated to like 40% was off the money. It has really, really gone down. And you know, I had to sell everything and proceed. Are you with me? So that is that. For today, I don't need any physical broker. Should I even tell you something that will shock you, class? My broker right now is Mr. Samson. Since when I have been trading, I've never seen him for once. Are you with me? I've never seen him for once. Let's proceed. I had to make a flow chart to show you who exactly is controlling the forex market. Look at my screen very well. You observe that there is a major body that controls the forex market. And this is the central bank. The assistants are the major bank. The next one are the commercial banks and the market makers. The market makers are the brokers. Who are the brokers? The brokers are the Hot Forex, for instance, Infinox, so on and so forth. I will talk about broken firms tomorrow. I'll talk about brokers tomorrow. Now, my next slide, don't worry, class, feel free. Don't worry, just relax. I will still send you this slide. I'm just doing all of this for explanation's sake. I'll send you this slide and I'll send you the recorded version of this class. I am recording this class right now. Immediately and true. I will send it to you people latest before 10. You should have this class. But do me a favor. I'll be dropping this video on my YouTube link. Please don't forget to subscribe, share, you can like, so that you can always enjoy subsequent videos that will come up. Are you with me? That can really help. Are you with me? So let's proceed. So we have two types of currency, base currency and cryptocurrency. The first listed currency of a currency pair is called the base currency, and the second currency is called the cryptocurrency. Now, the first currency you see there is euro. The second currency you see there is USD. Now, class, it's just like when you say I have a pair of slippers. A pair of slippers is a constituent of two, left and right. So when you say currency pair, it's a combination of two currencies. And those currencies are always not the same. For instance, currency pairs will always be different. It is euro, USD. Euro is different from USD. Their rate is even different. GBP is different from AUD. Gold is different from USD. Are you with me? So now, what exactly the first listed currency there is euro. And the second one is the quote. For GBP AUD, The base currency is JPP, and the quote is what? AUD. For XAU USD, the base currency is XAU, and the other one is what? USD, which is the quote currency. Let's now see how important they are. Exchange rate. Exchange rate is the rate at which one currency will be exchanged for another. It is also regarded as the value of one country's currency in relation to another currency. When we believe that one currency rises against another, we buy the strong currency and we sell the weak currency. Another example is when you have a multi-billion naira company that needs to convert large amount of money into another currency. Like what I said, you travel to Japan, you take Japanese currency, you convert it. Sorry, you are trying to Japan. You take naira, you convert it to Japanese currency. That is a very good example of what exchange rates. Let's do a small mathematics. Onto my screen. What I'll be doing here will just be a slight calculation on exchange rate, and it's very simple. For instance, I have AUDUSD. For instance, I have AUDUSD. AUDUSD is actually an exchange rate. I am assuming, okay. Let's say probably AUDUSD is, check the value for AUD. I don't want to go into that now, but I just know I'm assuming, let's say the exchange rate is 1.24. 500. It's 1.24500. Then let's see who's in the house. Let's say Madam Informa sent an information that Mr. Gospower, AUD has increased in the market. Then let's say AUD increases in the market. Once it increases, let's say AUD has increased. If AUD has increased, let's say probably the new exchange rate is 1.27. Please, I'm assuming 1.27. Or probably, let me do something that will be so clear. Let me do something else. I want to assume, let's say AUDUSD. Let's say AUDUSD. AUD is, let's say AUD is 400. Then USD is 500. Class, 400 divided by 500, do your mathematics very well. That's 0.8. Now, if that's 0.8, please mute yourselves, please. If that's 0.8, let's say Mr. Toib called me that Mr. Gospower, AUD has increased in the market to 500. 500 divided by 500 is what? 1. So 500 divided by 500 is what? 1.000. Now let's say AUD now drops later. Probably AUD dropped to 300. I didn't say anything about USD class. I'm still on AUD. Let's say AUD dropped to 300. If AUD should drop to 300 divided by 500 is what? That's 0.6. Now, class, I want to say something quickly. If AUD is increasing the market, then USD should be dropping. I repeat, if AUD is increasing the forex market, then USD should be what? Dropping. So that means that from 400 to 500, there has been an increment. So what do you do in that case? You buy in the forex market. Now, class, look at this. If AUD should drop in the forex market, it means that USD is increasing. Oh, sorry, let me come again. If AUD is increasing the market, USD is dropping. You know, I didn't talk about the value of USD. I'm on AUD. If AUD is increasing the market, USD will drop. So you buy in the market. Vice versa. If AUD is dropping in the forex market, then USD is what? Increasing. So what do you do in that case? You sell. Class, if you think it's a lie, look at the values. There was a slight increment from 0.8 to 1.00. That is a signal of buy. And how can you predict this buy? It's when you work with some of your indicators, which I'll teach you later in subsequent classes. It's when you work with what? With some of your indicators. Look at this. When this one drops, this is a signal that what? You should sell. And you can only predict this when you work with what? With some of your what? Your indicators. Are you? So let's proceed. I know some people will have this in mind that when you are to buy, when a value is increasing, are you not supposed to sell? Hello, Bitcoin and Forex, they are two different things here. I am talking about Forex pair you are working with indicators. I'm not talking about Bitcoin here. I know that Bitcoin, when Bitcoin rises to its, like right now, Bitcoin is gradually going up. What are people doing now? People are diving into the market seriously. Why? Because the value is low. But if you remember very well, class, there was a time Bitcoin was I think 64, was it, is this $64,000 or so? Not like now that it's 48, it was 64. People were selling heavily. Those that sold then, they would have been so happy then, because there was a time when it dropped to what? 14. Imagine you left your money there and it dropped down to 14. What kind of loss is that? Are you thinking? So now that it went from 26, 20, people are already in the market. Even as at now that it's for something, people are buying. Bitcoin is not forex. I mean, it's just a different thing entirely. Although Bitcoin can be traded in this business. Don't worry, I will show you those things. Bitcoin can be what? Traded in this business. Thank you. On to my next slide. My next slide is fundamental and technical analysis. Fundamental analysis is a way of looking at the forex market, analyzing economic, social, and political forces. Now, let's be very, very realistic here. Last year, there was a whole lot of pandemonium in the world. And the trouble was that there is a coronavirus. You know, thank God for Nigeria, we didn't really understand what was happening, but it was a serious thing for those that were there. So many activities were shut down right here in Nigeria too. In that process, the market was very, very fast. If you trade a live account, you can testify to what I'm saying or demo. The market was very fast. Do you know that because that market was so fast, people lost a lot of money that period? But thank God for good indicators, good strategies. People still made it heavily. Are you kidding? People still made it heavily. So that is a very good example of economical situation. Political forces. Look at when Joe Biden and Trump early this year, they were really disturbing the market. When they came into the market, they were having their own political forces. It affected the market. A very good example of a currency pair that was highly affected was Euro GBP. Euro GBP is a currency pair. If I'm here, that's fact what I'm saying. Euro GBP is a currency pair that when you trade, as a last year, you'll be getting your results successfully. But early this year, down to a certain point, it wasn't like that. It wasn't easy. The market was really, 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 really terrible. So let's proceed. Now, they said The idea behind this type of financing is that if a country's currency outlook is good, its currency will strengthen. Are you with me? For instance, there are some natural disasters right now. There are some terrible situations going on in the world. Nobody would like to take their money and go to such countries to go and invest. It's not possible. Nobody would like to go into those countries and what? Go and invest because there's a terrible situation there. But in a country whereby you have good situations, guess what? You successfully what? Trade, and there will be no disturbance in those kind of cases. Like I was saying about Japan. If Japan is having a very big issue, I can't go to Japan. Are you with me? If Japan is having a big problem, I can't go there and invest. I'm investing, I'm taking my money there to go and buy parts. And I'm depositing a large amount of money in Bank of Japan. Are you with me? So I cannot do all those things for all those kind of countries. So let's proceed. The next one is technical analysis. Technical analysis is the study of price patterns on particular assets. There are many ways to identify patterns in the market. So technicians, we focus on using tools like Fibonacci level, chart pattern. They will use Bollinger Band. They will use moving average, so on and so forth. So all these things are what technicians they do. Technicians, we all only focus on doing all these things. Are you with me? In the name of winning in the market. Should I tell you something that will surprise you today? If you're a good, I used to hear people saying that I'm a technical analyst, I'm not a fundamental analyst. What stops you from being both? There are times I don't need to use my tools to make analysis. Once I just get to the fundamental analysis, I get the news. I will just know when to dive into the market and when to exit the market. I will teach you those things before. That's beyond policy. I'll dive into the market. And diving into the market, I'll profit heavily. Most times when I use trade, I profit heavily. Are you with me? When I use trade, I will profit above my expectations. Because, for instance, maybe a news came into the market that United States, USD has gone flat. Hello, I'm saying something. Let's say they say USD has gone flat. It has gone flat in two ways. If you are trading a currency pair like USD CAD, USD CAD, you know USD is the base currency and it has gone flat. In that case, you should sell that currency pair. Let's say that news came into the market 10 minutes ago. If you enter the market as a sell, hey, you never regret it. You even make more than your expectations. Another way that USD can be affected, USD has gone flat, is when you see a currency pair like GBP USD. Have it in mind that GBP is strong and USD is flat. In that case, what do? You buy that currency pair. Are you okay? So, class, I think I've come to the end of this section. If you have any question, you can just drop because this is the end of it. If you have any question for today, you can drop your questions. You can ask your questions, please. If you have any question, you can ask your questions, please. If you have any question, you can ask. If you have any question, you can ask. Please, like I said previously, because I noticed some of us, we are just coming in, I will drop the PDF and the video before 10. I'll drop it on my channel. Please don't forget to subscribe and share. Let others also benefit from what you are enjoying at the moment, because all this will go for 2 days. For 4 days. I joined late. No problem, Mr. Sai. There's no problem. Tomorrow is another day. Same time, 8 p.m. We shall meet in tomorrow's class. Since there's no question, thank you very much. God bless. I appreciate all of you for coming. I appreciate all of you for being part of this class. Thanks so much. Okay, somebody wants to ask a question. Mr. Murphy, ask your question. Unmute yourself and ask your question, please. Mr. Murphy, unmute yourself.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, good evening.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you, Mr. Gospar.
Yo, thank you so much. I appreciate you.
Your teaching was very enlightening. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'm a novice anyway. I just came into the market not quite too long.
Yes,
sir. And by grace of God, I want to stay in the market, and that's why God brought it to me. I hope to continue the meeting and learn more of it. For now, I understood all the things you taught today. I'm not sure. I'm not sure I have any problem with the class. Maybe tomorrow I'll go ahead and see. Thank you very much. I appreciate you.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it too, sir. Thank you so much. God bless you all. Like I said, class, don't worry. Even if you don't have an idea of how to trade, I am here to guide you. Day three, I will send everybody screen recorders on how to pick trades and how to set up MetaTrader 4. I hate me. I will do that. That's why I'm here. I understand. When I started to as a newbie, wow. In fact, everything was looking so strange to me. Until I had to disturb my mentor. He had to pull me through. And to the glory of God, I think I've gained this knowledge to a certain point. Thank you so much for appreciating my effort, Mr. Murphy, and the rest of your house. I appreciate it.
All right, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. So see you all tomorrow. Please don't miss tomorrow's class. Tomorrow's class is very important. Oh, somebody has dropped, raised his hand. Okay, speak. Speak. Thank you, class. Mr. Chukwu Ebuka, can you speak, please? I'm with you. Mr. Chukwu Ebuka, unmute yourself and speak. I'm with you. Okay. Mr. Chukwu Ebuka, can you unmute yourself and speak? I'm with you. Okay. I guess the man is having a network problem. Thank you very much, everybody. We shall see tomorrow. Good night, everybody. Good night.
Yeah. Hello.
Yes, hello, Mr. Toye. Good evening, sir.
Hello, please, Toye. I really enjoy your class very well.
Thank you.
So, and I appreciate what you taught us today. But I came in late.
No problem.
So I did not get much of it.
No problem.
Maybe tomorrow.
Yeah, I understand that some people they will just get back from work and they are trying to watch online. I understand all of these things. That is why I'm going to drop the video on this WhatsApp platform. I will drop the link on WhatsApp platform and I'll drop the PDF. You get this PDF.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Yeah. Okay. Right. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, good night. Thank you, Mr. OCR. I got your message. Thank you, everybody. Good night. Yeah.